Welcome to Let's Talk Video Production. Let's look at how to add an end screen to your video in YouTube. Hit the subscribe button for tips, how-tos and videos about business and video marketing. So what is an end screen? An end screen is an overlay that sits on the end of your YouTube video and encourages your viewers to engage with your channel or brand further. That might be watching more videos, subscribing, or visiting a website. This is created in YouTube and not in the editing process. So how do you add an end screen in YouTube? First, log into your account and go into the edit screen for the video that you want to edit. So you might be looking at the video and you'll see an edit button below it, or I'm in the video manager here, so I'm just going to go in and edit this video. And you'll see a menu of items across the top here. Select End Screen and Annotations. And that will take you to the tool where you create your end screen. Select Add Element here on the right, and that gives you the drop down of the elements that you could add. Find the one that you want to add. We will add a video, so press Create next to that. And you've got three options here. So we could select it to show the most recent upload, or allow YouTube to select what it thinks is best for the viewer, but I want to put a specific video on here, so I'll choose a video or playlist. So you can see single uploads here, or your playlists. If you want to add a particular video or playlist, you can put the URL into this box here. And I want to put a single video in, so I'm going to select that one, and it will highlight, and then press Create Element. Now it's placed that element on the screen, and you can see here's the rectangle, so it needs to be within that space. You can move it about, you can make it bigger or smaller, and that's the biggest and the smallest it will go there, so I've shown you the full range. So resize it, place it on the screen where you want, and now let's set the timing for how long the element will show on screen. Beneath the video here, we see a timeline that has the element on it as a bar, and that's showing how long it's showing for. So can't be any longer than 20 seconds, can't be shorter than 5, that's as short as it's going to go. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try and place this playhead to come in at the start of the end screen credit that I've created there. You can see I've made these graphics. Do design your end credit to take your end screen into account, leaving the desired space on screen and timings, plus any useful calls to action or graphics that you want to include on there. So you can see the playhead sitting on the elements timeline below the video. And so you change the start by pulling the left hand side. You could change the end by pulling the right hand side here. But usually they're just left to play to the end of the video. So set the timing for how long the element will show on screen, and I'm just going to quickly add a few more elements. So I'm going to put a playlist. I'm going to put my how-to for video marketing playlist in there, so create that element. And also I'm going to put a subscription button in there, and there you go, that shows it will show your profile picture. Let's just place those. I could change the timings of those elements to show at different times, but I'm going to keep them all together. And remember to press save, or you're going to lose all your changes. So I can see all my elements in a list on the right hand side here. If I wanted to go and edit them, I could do that. I could change the video that's showing, or I could delete the element with a little trash can icon there. But remember to save after every time that you've done that. If you want to preview the end screen, you can press the preview button on the top of the video here.
And you're done. Hope that was helpful. If it was, you're helping me.
And that pretty much just shows the end screen in itself. If I wanted a bit more context, I could move the playhead on the video here, or the playhead on the elements timeline. Just click on a different spot and then press the play button.
And you're done. Hope that was helpful.
And it just gives you a bit more context of where that end screen comes in. A really handy tip is you can reuse the end screen you've created across other videos by selecting Import from Video. So let's say I used the same one that I created on that video there. So you select the video and press Import and Confirm. And what that does is it will bring in an end screen that you put on another video and overlay it onto this video that you're currently editing. Bear in mind that if you change the timings of that end credit, you would want to change those to fit. Next to the Import from Video button, you've got the Use Template button as well. There you can select a template that YouTube has already created. But I like to do it my own way, so I like to build my own end screens. The elements that you can add to an end screen are video, which might be a single video or a playlist, subscription button, which shows your profile picture, a link to a channel, someone else's, a website link. So this is a link to an external website, but you must be on the YouTube Partner Program to have this. which means you must have had 10,000 views across all your videos before you can apply to join. You must add at least one video element, and you might just have that video element, but what you wouldn't be able to do would be to have just a subscription button without the video element. You can have up to four elements on your end screen. The video that you're adding the end screen to must be at least 25 seconds long, and the timing of your end screen elements must be between 5 seconds and 20 seconds. You have a restricted area within which you can place elements. This appears as a rectangle on the editing screen, and you are limited to how big or small you can make those elements. The end screen should show up on apps in mobile devices, but it may not show up in the browser in those devices. And that's it, hope that was helpful. If it was, you're helping me out by giving this video a like. Maybe you know someone who'd find this useful. Please do share and subscribe to stay in touch and get tips for your video content marketing. Thanks for watching.